Hello everyone, once again welcome to this today's webinar. Manikantha sir, we can begin with your introduction if you are ready and
yeah, take it. I'm ready. You want to wait for a few more minutes? We can wait, otherwise we can start.
Yes, sir. We can wait for one more minute at
sure,
4 to exactly we can start. Thank you, sir.
Sure. Okay. So, hello everyone. This is Manikandan TJ from TJ Photography and Design Studio, Bangalore. So, I basically do majorly fashion and advertising photography. So, what we're going to do today and what you're going to share today is like what all I did and how I become a fashion photographer and what points which I, you know, which made me as a fashion photographer and how we can work as a fashion photographer and a lot of things. And also about what equipments we're going to use and what kind of lights we required and so many things will be there. And slowly, one by one, I'll go. Okay. So hope you all ready. And I will showcase some of my work, which most of you not seen in the web because it's an advertising material because sometimes you cannot use those in your profile also. So here I'm going to present most of them, whatever I have done so far. So it will be interesting, and also some of the place I will stop, pause, and I will talk about the image, what I have done, how I made this image and stuff like that, so that you will get some more idea on how we made those images. Those are the major part we want to cover. We have an hour to present, and also we have some time to discuss about things. And also if you have anything, any questions, you definitely yes, you can ask at the end of the session. We will be answering from our side, and also from Mr. Namesh Kamesh also, sorry, Mr. Kamesh also will answer if you have any technical questions. Okay, let's start. I'm gonna present some of the work, for some of my work which I have done so far, and also some little tips and tricks here and there I will cover, so that will help you to become a photographer and become a fashion photographer. So that's what I believe now. Okay, let's see. Let's start. I'm going to share the presentation and let's begin. I will talk, and yes, I hope guys you can watch only. At the end, of course, we can discuss on the question and answers. Okay. Hope everyone can see now. Okay.
Yes, sir, we can see.
Cool. Okay, yes, that's what it is. This is TJ from TJ Photography and Design Studio. So what is fashion photography as such? So we need to know, we need to understand a few things which is related to what we're going to talk today. So these are the quick things which I made for this presentation. So fashion is majorly about showcasing the clothing and material and the designer design style and the stitching pattern and the way they stitch, the way they're going to fit, all matters. And also including the fashionable items, which we say generally a product photography as such, but it includes in this fashion photography. So there are a lot of different kinds of watches, shoes, bags, and beauty products and more. So these are the things which is, you know, the base which we do work for the clients. So after these things, if you have a brand, like any brand you take as a clothing brand and as a fashionable items like shoe brand or watch brand, and we're gonna do a conceptualization and theme, which comes from advertising agencies. So as a photographer, you don't have to worry about the conceptualization and theme, because there are a lot of advertising agencies in this market. They do have their own client and they work for those brands. So then they will be coming up with very nice concepts and themes. Then they will connect with the photographer whom they know, or sometimes the client will directly approach the photographer with some concept. So that's how this works. So the theme, once the theme is done, then photographer is hired for so and so money, and there will be a lot of things which we need to think of when you do a fashion photography. It's not like only a photographer can do fashion photography, because you definitely need one person or a model or a product, and then you need a very nice stylist to do things, and also a talented makeup artist, which they have to provide what is the requirement from us and from the client. So those are the things, minimum required team. Then we have assistants and so on. So, and also it is majorly, you know, you have to know the location. If you're shooting indoor, if you're shooting in a studio, it's a different situation. But if you're going somewhere out or you're hiring a location, then you need to understand the location, how the location going to support you and how you can make things better. So these are the things which we need to start and keep in mind before starting anything as a fashion photographer. So the client side and photographer, then photographer team, and everything mix and match, and to produce a best result. Then after doing everything, and it goes for post-processing, editing, then it goes to print medium, magazine, brochures, products, and online medium. Okay, then I'll go like this only, slowly, whatever I have done as a PPT. So you guys can watch everything. And if you have any question, please do connect in the end, so that we will be there to answer your all the questions. Thank you. Then next, how to start fashion photography and what equipments do we require? It's a major question which everyone has in their mind. Sir, I want to become a fashion photographer, but I don't know how to start. Sir, I have only on DSLR and kit lens. Can I do fashion photography? See, Hindi, I cannot do right now, sir, because everyone is from every part, so I cannot do in Hindi right now. Okay, so how to start fashion photography and what equipments do we require? So if you ask me, any camera you can use, any lens you can use and make a perfect fashion portraits or fashion photography, but it depends on the requirements. If you are shooting for yourself, if you are doing only for yourself, and any camera will work, any lenses will work. And if you are doing only for online, certain pixels will work. If you are doing for hoardings and if you are doing for magazine printing, then you have to level up your pixels also. So we have to divide into 3-4 different ways to make your fashion photography start. Okay, I will start with the basic things, which how I started in general. Before that, I'll tell you, I spent an advertising almost 14 years from the retoucher to creative lead in many different multinational ad agencies. Then I became a photographer. So I worked with a number of big photographers in the industry to understand how they work and what their style and et cetera, et cetera. So I learned a lot from them. And we used to direct any kind of ads is going to come. So we used to explain the photographer that this lighting has to be like this. This light has to come from this. And I have to lit this model also. If I'm using a sofa, that's the sofa is important. The sofa also has to be lit nicely and et cetera, et cetera. So that's how I gained my knowledge in lighting and photography and so. So now I'm a fashion photographer and I do, advertising photography also. So coming to this point, I'm telling you again, any camera, any lens, if you are a beginner level camera also, it's fine. Or you have a major latest release camera also fine. But you can do perfect fashion photography, but you need to understand few things, which I will tell you, slide by slide, you will understand what I am talking about and what is required to become a fashion photographer and also what is required to make a perfect picture. Okay. So this is a long back, this thing. This is just one event. So I'll show you a few picture of this one. Okay. So how to start fashion photography? If you don't have anything in your hand, you don't have a subject with you, and you want to make something to understand about fashion. As said in the beginning, fashion is about clothing and styling and makeover and so on and so on. So I suggest first step to attend a lot of events like fashion events. Okay. So go there and explore your camera first. So it will help you to understand a lot of things about the product and about how to make some images also. This I made images and it talked in the town because I used just a basic camera with 24-105 lens for this camera. Next to me, a lot of guys is already with 7200 and some of them has a prime lens, these, that. But I just went with my camera and with 24-105. But I made and I decided what to do over there because it's not after shooting and I coming back and I have done like this. Because if you are not if you are not planned before what you're going to do, you cannot achieve such things. Okay, so what I did is I know the limitation of my camera and the lens, what I can capture. Okay, so what I did is I did one long shot, that's a wide shot, and also one tight shot of the same thing. Then I did a post-processing to connect these two. So this is how you need to start a little bit of thinking about how you can make any simple image to get better and present better. This is what I did in the beginning. I'm talking about, it's not only about the beginning, I'm talking about the basic camera and basic lenses. You can make such things and make more things. So now, everyone knows photography is all about light, but you should learn about lighting. Lighting is not only just light, okay? So you need to understand how the light is going to impact the subject or a space or a product. Those are the very important thing which we need to understand as a photographer and anywhere you go, actually. So if you are carrying an external light or a speed light, or you don't have a light, you don't have to worry about. But only thing you should know about how the light is falling, from which side is falling, and how it will impact your subject. So those are the things which you need to always remember whenever you stand. If you're sitting now itself, wherever you're sitting, maybe you are somewhere in the tube light or you are in an open space, and you cut and see how much light will cut and how much light you can gain. A lot of things you need to understand about lighting before you want to make some nice images. So understand the lighting, intensity of the lighting, and how it will behave in your subject or a model, etc. So that's what I have wrote here. Understand the light, how it will affect just as a light. Learn just as a light. If you are using a mobile light also, it's fine, or you are using an ambient light also fine. But you need to understand the light, because any light, if you are closer to the light, it will give more bright image. If you are far, it will give soft light. But at the same time, when you are close to the light, the diameter of the light will be less, and if you go far, the diameter of the light will be more, but the intensity of the light will be less. So those are the things, simple things, but you should learn and understand. It's learning is different, understanding is different, and a lot of things you can make it perfect when you look at a light itself. Then that's what I said. Understand how much it will affect the subject. Understand the detail it's going to produce in your photograph. And yes, majorly, when you say, sir, it is photography is all about light. But what is going to define is the shadows of the light. So that is also very much important. So if you have an open light source, then you will get a lot of harsh shadows. And if you are very far from the light, then you will get a very softness in the shadows. And also understand the distance of your shadows. If you put a light from top, then light from top, and you move here and there, you will see how the light and the shadows moves. So then it makes a perfect image. So these are the key points when you do any kind of photography, but especially in fashion photography, you must understand the lighting of the subject, how to light the subject, how the light reacts on the subject. That is more important than anything else in fashion photography. Now I just few things which I have done, so I will just run through, and then another slide will come. I will stop there and I will talk. Okay, hope you can see properly. Then this is for LP. This is just for indoor, indoor branding for them. And this is for one brand called Bren. And always remember, where are the highlights? And see, I kept just like that this image, because you should understand the light is from where it's coming. I just used one beauty dish on top, nothing else, no extra light in this, just one light. And these images, most of the images are not edited, because generally, if the client requirement is there, then we edit. If they required edit, then we'll charge extra for that. So always remember, if you are quoting anything as a photographer, fashion photographer, everything you need to divide apart. Photography and editing, these two is a major role it's going to happen, because any fashion photography, if you are not retouching, or if you are not editing, mainly for advertising, it's definitely required. Post-processing is a must to apply. Okay, so if you see here, I used one light, and this is a purely an e-commerce shot. It's a white background and just lit. So I have used almost 4 light to fill this image proper. And if you see this image, I have done very long for Carbon Mobiles. He's an actor, Akhil Nagarjuna. And if you see here, we have outdoor also and indoor also. And we have to light him. And also, if you see both the side, we have glasses. So you need to understand how this light is going to affect on the subject. And it should not be reflect on the mirror, sorry, on the glasses also. So if you are, if it is going to reflect on the glass, then you will have extra work to edit and stuff like that. So always remember that when you lit a subject, your surrounding also matters. So understand how the angle is gonna work. So here I have used two lights actually, from the left and also from the right, but it's completely above above the subject, so that it's not reflected on the glasses. And this is also a single light. And also remember, it's not like you will have a lot of choices when you do for a client requirement. Because when the client says he wants like that, we can improve and give, but we cannot add a lot of things to them, because they will be having their own presentation, and they will be having their own media coverage and how to promote and stuff like that. So we will be having a lot of choice before you come to this shoot. You have to meet them, you have to do a lot of groundwork, and we have to discuss with them. In general advertising, they will have a storyboard for a shoot. So they will be showcase where the subject to be and how the dresses to be and what kind of jewels, what kind of dresses you're gonna wear, what color, what kind of equipments you're gonna hold, everything, blah blah blah, everything has to be on your table to understand the perfect perfect situation for the photography. If you are not doing anything like that, just like that, if you go, it will be a problematic, because you will lose a lot of things. You didn't convey to the stylist, or you didn't tell the makeup artist, he may not get something what is required for the shoot, and a lot of things. Now if we see here, this is for Epson printers. So we have done a campaign last year, and you can see this lot of online campaigns also they have done. And if you see here, for example, this is how we shoot in the studio, indoor studio, but little bit setup will be there. See, now we have a table and they have a props, and they have the printer also. They have we have added light and these, that, these and all will be discussed before the shoot commences, before finalizing the date of the shoot, because all the things are very much important. The props, what they're gonna use, what kind of the props they're gonna use, why do they record, everything they will have in the storyboard. They will present to you, and the whole team you can present. Then it will help you to make it quicker. Because I will tell you about models. See, models is subject to lot of different ways. Most of the advertising will work 1 year contract. As in, if you are shooting for a product, or if you are shooting for any kind of brands, and if you are using these models, they will have some contract with them. And they will sign for the contract for a year. Some of them will give for a number of continuation years, and some will add extra. Okay, so you have to know what has to be done. You have to get signed with them. Those will be taken care by the agencies if they are directly connected with the model agency. If they are coming through you, and you have to provide everything, because that is major thing which we will be in problem when the issue rises. So always remember, so if you are doing a professional way, and these are the things you should keep in mind when you connect with model. Okay, and right now this campaign is up everywhere. This is we done for in July, we done for Byju's, Byju's app, learning app. So we have done, see this, we have done, went to the location, because this is not studio, this is not my studio. So we went to the location is not nothing but their office actually. So they want to do first in the green screen, and then advertising agency from Mumbai said, no money, you don't have to do it in green screen, because we will have a lot of problem. I will tell you the two different things. When you do a videography, if you are having a green screen, then easy to remove. But when you do a photography, if you are using green screen, if your subject, you have white subject and all, that green will reflect very badly, and you have lot of work to rectify them. And also if you see here how much editing is important, you will get to know. The below are the shots, okay, below are the shots. and above are the almost finished before texting text placement, logo placement. If you see here, we have done a variety of different, this is just showcasing just four images, but we used to do a few number of images because we have to get what they want, and there will be a art director with me, and also there will be someone creative director from the client side also. So you have to make sure that what is required, and you have to deliver that. If you are not delivering that, whatever effort you put, it's gone for a toss. So always remember, make sure what is required by the client first. After that, your experimentation and your improvisation will definitely help. But keep in mind, whenever you do any kind of photography, fulfill what is the requirement. Then add on your thoughts and your creatives. Okay? So that will help. Next. Who is that? Okay. So this is for... again, I'm talking about products here, and this is for Bugatti shoes, and this is again from an agency, but they want to showcase not only the products, and they want to showcase people also in it. And again, this is not completely edited images. This is how we shoot and give it to the client. If they require editing, we do editing. Otherwise, they do have their in-house editors to edit. So these are the few product shots we have done for Bugatti. And again, if you see this one, these are, it's all simple shots. But if you think on the left-hand side corner, if you see the shoes, two shoes, and the light is coming, nothing edited in that, okay? Okay, somebody is doing something. Just one second. You can see my presentation, right?
Yes, sir, we can see that.
Okay.
You can see.
I'm not able to get it. One second, people. If you see here, we have done a very simple shot in the left hand side, which is that it's almost unedited because we have used something in the below, and this is mainly about understanding light. Okay, so you have to understand light to achieve things, and everything can be done simply nice until if you are not getting the right lighting to the either the subject or a product. So always remember, again, I'm telling you, you should understand the lighting and how the light is gonna impact your subject. Yeah. So these are the few shots. This I'll hide. What happened? Okay. And also remember, the props makes a lot of difference. Okay, props makes a lot of difference. If you see here, it's a rough and tough shoe. That's what they told. This is done just like that. They given me the product. They didn't say anything else. So I have added, you should understand the product also, what that product used for and where we can use and stuff like that. Some of the client will give all the storyboard and everything they will discuss. Some won't discuss. They will give entirely to you. Especially if you are into creative field, and they definitely trust you and they will give you. So that's how I got this product, just like that, only the product, and I made myself all the props arranged, what has to be used and how we can use that and stuff, etc., etc. So always remember, adding your own thoughts is very much important than whatever it is there. But still, first we need to make them this is what required, we have delivered, and add your pluses to your photography. Then it makes a lot of value in general as a photographer, and especially into fashion or product shots, you have to be like that. This is a simple layout shot, but if you think, it's just a simple shot, but there are three or four people are working to place them right and to do things. Again, this is not an edited image. They have removed all the wrinkles, these, that, and all in the post. Yeah. Always remember this will look very simple, but when you're laying it out and there will be a stylist to help you, and then you have to light it nicely. After lighting also, after making the image also, there will be a lot of editing work on this product. Especially when you do a fashion and product, there will be a little bit more than you expect for editing. And yes, this is still unedited. It just cropped the image, but this is made using only single light. Okay, single light and reflector. I will talk about what and all that will come in the separate slide, but this just I'm talking about what I have done that time. These are the Seiko watches. I will tell you, they have sent product only to do e-commerce shoot, but I have add on this to understand what we can make difference when you shoot instead of just a white background, so that you can pitch in yourself that you can do these kind of stuff also, and also they can understand, okay, this is this capability of this photographer can do this way. So these are the plus point you have to keep in mind when you do any kind of shoot. They have given me just a product to shoot in a white background, this front, back, side. If you see Seiko website, you will see all entire list is done by shot by us only here. So those are the things which you need to, as a photographer, you need to pitch in. It's like a cross-selling still. But yes, of course, it will help you to make you understand that what you can do also, what you can present to the client also. So client will understand that this person is capable of doing this way. So we can do in the coming future, if anything comes in, they can give. So these are the small steps to how to become more efficient in making your client understand you more and more. And see this one. And this is also this old monk. Yes, of course, this is not released yet. And they said it's gonna be only up. They're gonna sell abroad. But they have given on reference that they need just like that only. So we created the same thing and we have done it. And yes, of course, a regular shoot for this Amrut also. This is an Indian company, and we do a lot of product shots for them. And this, if you see, it's not only photography, it's about photography plus editing. Not every product can be just like that you shoot and send, because the print, if you see in this label, it's not like a shot. I have replaced with the original artwork from the client. So we used to ask the original artwork of the labels and etc. So that it won't look bad. You can do very nice photography and whatever is there, very nice it will look. Everything you can get in this except these labels, because label is printed. So what happens now, there will be a lot of dots in that in the label. So whatever you do, if you zoom, you will see a lot of dust and a lot of dots in that. So what we do is generally, if you want to make it look nice, then we just get the labels and replace on top of the shot what we have done, and we skew it and we do mess and this, that and all to make it perfect. Yeah, always remember, product photography is like one deadly thing, but yes, if you want to make it perfect finish, you have to edit for sure. And at the same time, if you ask me, this is nothing we have done, it's just shot, okay, directly shot. So always remember, a lot of things you need to understand about when it comes to fashion, and it's fashionable items also matters. So here, these are the things which you need to understand. Yeah. Now, we have done some interior shots also. Okay. So far I have showed some of the work which I have done. Also, I'm going to show a few more. That I showed some products also, some things also, which just want to tell you, not only as a fashion photographer, you have to do this and do that, but any which case, you're going to use the same equipment to do everything, but you have to master those things, whatever you're going to do. And that is a key thing as a photographer. And when you do as a fashion photographer, as I said about the lighting and et cetera, et cetera. But yes, now I'm going to talk about few things, which is here. What is required? Lighting equipment. When you say lighting equipment, there is an indoor and outdoor lights. Basically, why it is made indoor and outdoor lights? Because a lot of things you can say indoors. In olden days, we will have no batteries are there. We will use only with the power connected. And then we'll be having flash, only flash is outdoor, which is speed light. Now we have different things and different brands and different speed it works. A lot of things are there nowadays. So now we'll talk about the strobe light. Strobe light is essential for fashion photography because it produces, compared to flashes and stuff like that, it produces very good light and reach. And speed lights, yes, of course, speed lights also you can use. I'm again telling you, only thing you need to understand the light, how the light is going to affect. Speed lights also can be used and make nice images, but only thing you need to understand is how the light is going to react on the subject and how much it is required. And because generally speed lights, if you use, sometimes you may not sufficient with the power of that one light. So people use two or three speed lights together and throw as a one source light. So it will help to reach more and produce more power and get the right output from the subject. And yes, of course, it's not wrong only use speed lights. Speed light, you can use only speed lights and make a lot of things, but you need more speed light, or you need to compensate in your camera a lot to reach more lights. So those are the things. Strobe lights are the best one which we use for anything in photography. It gives very good light and the color tones, etc. And I'm telling you, each and every brand has its own range of lights which throw different kinds of different kinds of intensity is there. It's not like you will get all of them are same tone, because there will be a different in Kelvin also. And also when you use a diffuser, if your diffuser matters a lot, okay, I will tell you in that. First I will finish this lighting equipment. So these are the things which we need to minimally to understand when you, as a lighting equipment, at least you need a strobe light or a flashlight. And VSR, without light also we can do fashion photography. Yes, of course you can do fashion photography without light, but yes, what you do is you will be searching for an outdoor location and you have to make something. But when you grow as an advertising photographer and you want to make something big and you want to print stuff like that, sometimes the outdoor lights won't be efficient, so that you have to add one or two light to make it a perfect output. So that's how I feel and I experience. So there are a lot of lights with external batteries, and now a lot of them have come up with inbuilt batteries. You don't have to worry about external batteries to carry, and just inbuilt battery, just take that light, aram se tuck tuck, fix it and shoot. So these are the lights which is required. I will tell you when I go to the next slides what happens, what kind of light we can use and where to use and stuff like that. So not only the lights, you cannot use the light just like that open fire, okay, because it will throw more light and you won't get control of the light. When you want to control a light, if you want to control a light, any light, you need at least a cutter, which is you need to cut the light or you need to diffuse the light. Yeah, so I just a few top which we generally people use for photography. So there are squares and strip boxes, and then there are octa and deep octa. Octa and deep octa is the very simple things which you need to understand. The deep is like this, so that is deep octa, and if it is very opened, then it's a normal octa. Deep octa will be like this, concave, okay? So then beauty discs, these are the few things which you need to understand. Beauty disc is used mainly for beauty shots. Beauty shots is about when you shoot above the bust and the face and headgears. When you use a beauty disc, it will give a beautiful light throw to the subject. You should understand all the diffuser, how it will react with your subject and how much throw you're going to get from the light. Each and every softbox will have different throw. Okay, I will tell you the square and normal octa. Excuse me, normal octa will give very nice, you know, wide range of light. Okay, and strip again, it will become a linear. It will give little directional light. Deep octa will be like this, and definitely it will give some kind of, you know, controllable light to the direction what you want. And when you use a beauty disc, and plus if you use a grid is a honeycomb grid, it will come with that. And if you connect with that, exactly where you want, you can turn the light and see. Okay, so beauty disc with metal reflector, and there will be a deflector also in that. So when I do only for this, I will definitely explain that. Now I'm explaining you what kind of diffusers we have here. And there are parabolic is like the deep octa only, but the light source will be differently mounted. Some of them will have inside the you know, you have to mount the light from this side. Some of them will have this side, and the adjustment for the light adjustment, there will be a rod front back we have to move to get control the light. And metal reflector is a small metal reflector which we use for reflecting our kick light. So I will talk about the kick light and stuff like that in the next slides. So those are the things which we use for you know, to make images. Okay, somebody is talking here. Yeah, okay, so these are the things which is very simple. We will be having a strobe light or a flashlight. Okay, those are the major thing which we use, and in combination with lot of different kinds of diffusers. Okay, those gonna make you lot of difference in your output. So yeah, so next, how many lights required to shoot any kind of fashion image? I believe in three minimum light, either which I call as a main light and fill light and kick light. So I will tell you, if you see the colors here, main light and fill light is in blue and the kick light is in red. And if you see the center round is a person, if you think as a person, and there will be one main light in front of a subject. There is a one main light which is in front of the person, which is gonna fill, which is gonna affect the subject, which is called key light or main light, whatever it is you can call. Okay, that is the main light. So we call it, as technically it's called key light. And there is one fill light in this side, which is we need to add. It's not like if you see this image, I have kept a key light is from this side, so it will hit here. So what happens is it will be hit more. This side will be darker. So what happens is I need to add one more light to fill this area. Either you can use one more light, or you can use just a reflector. You know, the reflector you will get, or a white cloth also, or a thermocol also you can use to fill in. So what happens is this light will reach here and it will reflect. So it won't be very dark the other side. So these are the two major lights. And one more light is a kick light. Generally, we give from the back of the subject, which to make sure there is a differentiation between the subject and the background. Okay, if you are shooting on a black and black, and the hair has to be visible, or somehow you need to showcase the difference between the background and the subject. So that time, what we do is we use a kick light. So that is very much important to understand. It's a minimum three lights required to make a decent good image for sure. I am telling you three lights, but if you are using if you are shooting outdoor, I believe one light also works nicely. If you have two lights, then it's a plus point for you. Okay, always remember, outdoor If you shoot with and without light, you will see a lot of difference in your image, and the quality of the image will be definitely different. Okay, always remember that. So indoor, I suggest if you have a three light off, or if you have only two light, for the fill light, you have to use a reflector or a thermocol to fill in. So those are the minimum requirement. So two lights you have and one reflector you have, you are game. And also if you are doing an outdoor shoot, same way, if you have two lights or single light, one light can be fill in the shadows, one light can be fill in the one light can be filled from the kick light, or you can use a diffuser or a reflector to make sure it's not very much shadows, you can reduce. So those are the minimum requirement. But yes, of course you can use a number of light to create one single image, because it's needed. Sometimes you need it. If you are shooting in a large hall and you cannot trust one light to reach everywhere, okay, so what you have to do is you have to light the subject separately, and you have to light the product separately, and you have to give the separation, background separation you have to give, and if you are using a props here and there, then props also to be lit. So to start, I believe if you have one light and one reflector, you can do a lot of things. But I from my experience, I believe if you have a minimum three light, you can make amazing images. Trust me, you can do a lot of great images. So this is about how many lights required. So I believe three lights, it will work, it will do wonders. If you are doing for outdoor, I believe two lights will make amazing images. So again, I'll continue a few more shots. So now if you see from here, these are all just created myself, conceptualized, and we have done a lot of workshops like this. So these are the few images which I share, few more images I'm gonna share in this. So that will help you to understand what we can do with as a photographer, and how to conceptualize any kind of photography. So this is we done, I think 2015 or 16. It's a tribal thing. It's like she's not a real tribal, she's an African model. But yes, if you see the makeup, how much it gone inside, and the props what she using, all matters a lot. And in post process also matters to convert color also, it's fine. And this blood and all I have added in post processing, it's not shot directly. When I shot, it was just without blood, but the expression, everything has captured in that moment. Whatever she's holding in hand is just a key for, okay. So what I thought is, suddenly I thought I'm gonna shoot, and everyone was afraid to shoot in wide angle lens that time. Then I thought, okay, let me do something in wide. So I made the model to sit down, and I just made I think it's a 16mm only I used, 16mm, I just down and just click. So here also I have used two lights, okay. None of the images without light I used. More 90% of them, 90-95% of them is used lights. So here also we use two lights, one in the beauty dish, but little far. This is an outdoor shoot, but still we have used a beauty shot with the cloth. It's a diffuser cloth, not the grid, diffuser cloth, and one for the background. And this is a simple shot, one beauty dish and little in the back. And if you see here, it's also a simple shot. It's a white background shot, but still we have played three lights here. What we have done is one light mainly kept only to create that shadow in the back. If you see that one line is showing in the corner, that is only one light which kept only to create that shadow. And if you see in the front, and then we have used one key light in the front, and this side I just used one strip light to lightly fill. That's it. So here I have used three lights.
Sir, you will have to resume your presentation. Somebody else started presenting in between.
Okay, I'll resume.
Just say resume, yeah.
One second. Yeah.
It's
come?
Hit the resume, yeah.
I'll start again.
No, this just click the resume. Yeah, it's full screen now.
Okay, cool. It's come, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Okay, now this image is particularly, these all shot, this one are all shot using Z7, Nikon Z7 and 50mm. I showed this only to understand how detail you will get when you shoot with the strobe lights. So always remember what is required. See, I shot only the left hand side, but I didn't like the whole thing to present, as in I didn't like that, but I still like the detail of that thing which gave me as a close up. So I cropped that image and I have retouched it and used. So always remember a lot of things. I think you people can see properly. And also remember, everyone's screen is different, and somebody using LED monitor, somebody using different. The colors will be different for sure. And I will talk about the colors in the final, okay? I will tell you about what works and what not works. So this is an outdoor shoot, late evening shot. Here I have used only one light actually to fill. That time also I used a small beauty dish, but it was kept little far from the subject, and with the full power I did, because the light is completely gone, we don't have time, we have to rush. But still I like the way the designer he made it completely, just I don't want to miss the shot, so I made it quickly and shot this one. Hello. Okay, this one, if you think here, just remove the bottle, you don't worry about the bottle. I'm just talking about the subject and the back, that car. So when we went for a location and we don't know what to do and we have to do something interesting, then I saw this car opposite house, and then I went and talked to them, that the house owner and the car owner. I told him that, sir, we are doing this one, can I borrow your car? So he was looking at me and he said okay. So finally he gave. Then we came out and we took this car out and we shot this shot. And again this one we shot using super wide angle. I think again 16mm I used. So showcase is a different way of making a perfect picture. And yes, of course, it is edited after that, the background and all. And this one again, wide angle lens we have used, but still the light we have used is a single light here. And if you see on the right side, the light is coming out from the outside, that also giving a nice highlights. And also the light what we have thrown on the subject also gives a very good light. And this one is mainly, this is completely edited image. I could have added that before after, but still I forgot to add that. But still, yeah, these are the things which you can do when you do photography, and then post-processing also matters a lot. I just go through slowly. Let's see.
I cannot do it. Yes.
Hello?
I'm turning off their mic, sir. Give me.
Yeah. Okay.
Excuse me, sir. Some people cannot see it in their pictures.
Are you on a mobile? Okay. Let me help. Are you on a mobile? Sir, we are able to see. Don't worry. I'll assist them. Are you on a mobile?
Yeah.
No, sir, I'm on the laptop.
So on laptop,
I'm on mobile. I cannot see the.
If you are on mobile, then at the top there will be a pin option. Please unpin that.
Yes, I can see now.
Okay. Cool. Okay. So if you ask me, I have done this tribal thing thrice actually, because we went and went to this location actually before we decided what theme we're gonna do. So one of my friends said, Mani, come, let's go and see, that place was looking nice. Then, but I have to do some nice workshop, but at the same time, I don't have any theme in my mind to produce these images. So what I did is, me and him, we went to the location, we saw the red tree house and these that and stuff like that, a nice tree inside the place itself. Then we thought, okay, when we are having lunch and we are seeing the whole place was very nice, and it felt, you know, it triggered me that it's not like now modern thing, but still it gives me a rustic feel of you know, forest feel and stuff like that. Then suddenly, while having food and we are discussing, and suddenly we got a thought of tribal. Why not tribal here? So we have to make something interesting than a normal photography. So then we decided that we should do a tribal feel to the whole thing. That's how we created this images, and the amount of work got into this one was very, really a lot of things we spent, because suddenly when you say a tribal, but we don't know how to mix with, you know, now and then. So I thought of making a modern tribal, but still we will make something good output from the workshop. So these are shot completely in that situation. And again, I'll tell you, this is a teamwork. It's not only me. As a photographer, it's not like you cannot do just like that. We need a team. Again, stylist, again, makeup artist, and the people who are going to help for the garments and designers, blah, blah, blah. Lot of things are there to make it, produce one campaign or an image. So always remember, there is a combination of people to produce a perfect output. And if you have any concept also, you have to discuss with your team whom you have to final before you're going to talk, okay? Why I'm telling you is, a lot of people who do misuse. So always remember, if you have a thought, if you're going to do something very nicely, and you decide whom you're going to go with, either a makeup artist or a designer or whoever it is, okay? Or your friend or whoever it is. But decide who will work perfect for your subject, for your concept. All is very much important. Then you proceed to the next. So that will help you to make it perfect and mind free. Okay. If you have everything in your mind, and if you are not able to express to the artist who's going to come, it's very difficult to get output what you expected. So always remember, interaction is very much important with the whole team. And after coming, all the models will be there, and if you are not telling the model what you required, so she just holding like this, what she has to do, where she has to look, that is also important, and how she need to hold, how she need to look, everything matters, how the dress should be, how everything matters. So everything you have to explain them. If you are not explaining, or if you are not talking to the model, you cannot make a perfect. What you're thinking in your mind, you should express yourself, or you have to do it, go and sit on the top of the car and show, I want like this. So that is important. So always remember, if you are not able to communicate to your expression, just go and do it on the place where she or he need to do the posture. So that will help them to understand easily, and you also can express in that manner to get a nice output from the project. Yeah, so always remember, it's a teamwork, not only the surroundings, and the models who's going to come also matters a lot. So make them comfortable, and make sure they understand what you are looking for. That makes a lot of difference. I have seen a lot of people who come here, I have done a lot of workshops, but they won't talk to the model. If you are not talking to the model, if you are not explaining what is required, then it's very difficult to get to your shot. She can pose or he can pose like this, like that, but end of the day, it's just a click, but nothing to say that it's from you. Okay, always remember that if you want to make something unique or yourself, and you have to express nicely to the team and the model. If you do that, definitely you will make some nice. It's a very big tips which you need to make sure that what you have in mind is very much important. And if you are not satisfied, you cannot satisfy anywhere else. Okay, always remember that. So whatever you do, if you are taking a 100 shot or 10 shots, that is a different thing. But if you should get what is required or what you are thinking, I believe in that in general. So you have to make sure what is required. So try to convey them, make it happen. That will help you as a photographer. And for your conceptualization from your thought, everything will matter a lot. But yes, of course, it's not like just like that you can do. It will come in the experience. And some people have their talent to talk very nicely to anyone who comes as a stranger also, they can talk. But those are the kind of things which we required in general in when you do a business or when you do a shoot. It should be like, you know, it should go like a casual thing. Then productivity will be very nice. If you are not gelling with or if you are not interacting, it's very difficult to make nice things. Yeah, always remember that. Then see this expression, very simple expression, but if you are not telling her anything, it will look like a normal image. You know, she will be just looking straight to your camera and you will be clicking with a nice light and expressions less. So make them active. What is the theme? What is required from that subject? So make them understand. She has to shout, she has to scream, or she has to do pose. Everything has to be, we have to say. Some models will pick up just like that. She is like rocked that day because we said in the morning that this is what we're going to do. And this is like a tribal, but still you are a modern girl, but you have to act and behave like a tribal. But it's not only when a stranger comes to a tribal space, how you react, just do it. So that's how we got these kind of images. So always remember that if you are not communicating or if you are not expressing, it will be very difficult to achieve what you have in mind. Yeah. Again, one wide angle shot on top of the car. Okay, cool. This is recently edited last month, 2 weeks before. This is, I'll tell you, this is why I have selected this image. This is only one light I use. There is no fill light, nothing. Okay. There is only one light I used, which is on a deep octa, which is 70 centimeter deep octa, which is kept almost 4.5 feet away from the subject and exactly 45 degree on top of the subject on a boom stand. Boom stand is a L stand you will get. There will be a stand and on L stand, you can connect your light on that. I have used only one strobe light, which is, I think I used Elinchrome FRX 400. On a deep octa, 70 centimeter octa will be like this, and then it is lit from the straight and top, 45 degree straight and 45 degree top. If we note here, you can see a lot of shadows played behind her also, and also if you see the nose, the shadow. Okay, those are the important things you need to understand when you do a photography. Lighting and the shadows, very much important. Lighting and the shadow, how the shadow reacts. If I move this light in front towards little more front, the shadow of the nose, no, it will come down. Okay, always remember that. So those are the things which you need to see when you shoot. And I will tell you, if you're doing an indoor shoot, then you can switch on your bulb. As in, there is a modeling bulb inside the any light. So if you switch on, you will know the direction of the light. But if you do outdoor, you won't understand how it will react. So there you'll have a little difficult task. But if you're doing an indoor controlled environment light, then you can switch on the modeling lamp and see where the light goes and how it hits. So then you can click. So especially I made this image with single one light image. Yeah. And if you see here, same model. Okay. Same model. Okay. Same girl. Same model. I will tell you why I am telling you. See, there are different ways of looking at as a photographer, as a person, as a thinking, the way you think. So each and everyone have their character, and it all makes when you use a proper attire for things. So always remember that when you shoot, that is very much important to understand whatever concept you are having in your mind. So the subject also should work for your concept, and he or she should look better in that picture, and the garments you're going to use and the props you're going to use, the location you're going to use, everything matters to make it perfect. Okay, so here I used two lights, only two lights I use. It's already more than 7 p.m. I guess it's already fully sun is dead. So what I did is I key light is in front. I used a beauty, this bigger one, which is 70 centimeter bigger one, only with the not beauty this sorry I think I used only the deep octa, whatever I have used here. Okay, whatever I have used here, only a deep octa which is used in the front, which is the key light which is coming in, the main light which is coming from the out. And if I have used only one light, you could have not seen this image nicely, because one more light, I lit from inside to this window. Okay, if that light is dead, and the whole thing will be like only her will be lit, it won't give that feel to the whole image. Personally, I feel like that. Then I thought, okay, let me do one light from inside and one light as a key light. So that light has become a kick light also, and also a fill light type. So it solved me a purpose of this. And if you see here, two images of edited images. One side I have made like a vintage feel, because I have given speedier tone and converted to black and white and reduced the black and white to achieve that image. And this side is simply just convert to black and white and made less amount of that black and white layer on top of this. So I used two lights for this image, and same light but in a different angle. So what I thought is, it was looking, everyone is looking straight in this side, and let me try from this side also. So you should explore when you shoot anything in a location. Same thing, just black and white, and we have added few more props here, just this one and in color. And this gave me very pleasant feel because of the contrast of the dress and the contrast of the place. That place is, it's a full of mud house. It's a mud house. So it is mud and the brick red, and the color was brick red. So we have added two lights, only two lights, same light I have used here. So always remember that how you want to make. I could have made this also black and white, it would have been looked nice, but still I want to showcase the different. It's all shot in Nikon Z7. I think 50mm 1.8 I used. It's all images shot in Z7 only. And yeah, this is an indoor shot. Again, it's a tribal feel we have given. These tree plants and all is there in the side and all. We hired the tree, you know the nursery is close by your place. What I did is quickly, okay, this, if you see this ornaments, what she is wearing, and the jewels is provided by a stylist called Manju. He is very much into this, and he has a lot of things like that. So when I thought of doing one more tribal, but I need to do an indoor, a little different way. So then I decided to do something interesting this way. So same makeup artist and the stylist, I got a very nice props I got this time, and lit very nicely. If you see this right side image, we have used three lights minimum. If you see this same again on the left hand side, the girl who is holding the pot, this also we used three lights. One, there is a kick and one key light and one fill light. So far, if you see most of the images, I have used three or two lights only. Okay, I'm talking about this kind of version. And if you see here, this is the same thing, but different models and different thoughts I had. The left hand side is the international models. So I thought I need to make, look pleasant and very simple, just a beauty shot type. But right hand side, I need to make a lot of contrast, and I need to add more of a texture in it. what we did is just like we played with the mud. You know, the mud you can get in anywhere. In a organic shop, you'll get a mud roll. So I bought that one, and we applied on her. One model, we applied powder type. The makeup artist got something for specially for that. These are the few simple shots, but still, you know, it makes little impact than you do just like that a shot. And always remember, when you add anything as a prop or a makeup, it makes lot of different in it. If you see here, on the left hand side, it's a plain shot. There is no high too much makeup, but it's a beauty shot, definitely, yes. But in the right hand side, we have played with lot of things, but almost the same, the way they feel or same, but it looks contrasted, it looks completely different. Always remember simple things. If you add a prop or if you add something, it makes a lot of wonders. Okay, right. Here also, like, I used only three lights. There is a kick light and fill light and kick light. Yeah, so this is the thing which I have, and I will go back one little step. I will show you, because these on all I used two lights, one light, three lights. I will show you these and all. It's like you have to use multiple lights to create. I will show you the fashion one. Okay, these and all we use 4-5 lights. Okay, we have to fill in completely the subject. It's not like dramatically lit, it's a flat lit, but still you have to differentiate the kick light and the key light. So we have used more than 4 lights here to fill the back, fill the subject, fill the product, fill the tables, etc., etc. Here also same way, I have used on the top right hand side, we have used 3 lights. That's it. Those, all of them, most of them I shot 2-3 lights or 4 max. Very particular shots, we have used more than 3 lights. So that's why, in my experience, if you have 3 lights, you can make amazing output. Now I will go once again. Okay, hope this thing I have made to understand these things. And yes, what I love to do to relax when I get time or when I want to do something different, I just go and do wildlife and I do macro photography. It makes me think differently, and it relaxes my mind. Always keep the mind cool, because if you are not keeping it cool, you cannot think a lot, you cannot do things better. Always remember, make things simple and clean. And yes, of course, these are all shot using lights. Okay, it's not shot just like that. Most of the shot we shot in the night, after 8:39. So that time also used two lights. I have used 2 lights also, which is flashlights, and I used some diffuser for that. This also used lights and we shot. Okay, thank you. Kamesh sir?
Great, sir. Thank you. We will take some questions from the. If somebody wants to unmute themselves and ask any questions, you are free to ask them now. Otherwise, we will start taking questions from the chat only.
Sure, sir.
Hello, sir. Which type of strobes are you using? What path?
I'm using, till now, I'm using only Elinchrome lights. I have Elinchrome FRX 400, 600. That's it. Those are the lights I use. Whatever images you see is completely shot using Elinchromes. Hello.
Great, sir. Like, if they would have got their answer, they would.
Yeah.
Understand.
Hello, sir.
Yes, madam.
I just wanted to ask you whether one should buy AD200 2 lights or 1 light of AD400. Like, what do you suggest if one wants to buy?
See, if you want to go with simple lighting, and yes, of course, AD200 is also good. You can go ahead and single things you are using. And what purpose you going to use? How much you going to play with also matters. Okay. If you are doing a majorly advertising these, that and all, then it is very difficult to, you know, do with only AD200. Yes, of course, AD200 also giving very nice light. I have used once. It's giving very good light, very good output also. Yes, of course, you can try that. But suggestion, if you are doing little more, if you want to invest now itself, at least you can go for instead of AD200, go for 400 Pro, which you have released now. That will help you for a long run. Okay, that's what I think. AD200 is good for now and cheap and best. I suggest that. But if you want to go for a long-term plan, if you have in mind, then I suggest wait for some time, make some money and buy the 400 Pro or 600 Pro. 400 Pro, at least it will help. Definitely, you can make a lot of difference in your image. But AD200 is fine. But I suggest if you are thinking on a long run, use 400 Pro.
Thank you, sir. Another thing which I wanted to ask was, what should be the size of the diffuser or the octa box? What size is generally recommended?
Octa box is very simple thing, which is if you use a 70 centimeter, is very good. And I use major shot with that only. 70 centimeter deep octa will help you. Okay. With the diffuser, without diffuser, it makes lots of difference. But yes, 70 centimeter deep octa is nice. It's a standard and traditional, but still effective.
Thank you, sir.
Yep.
Sir, what about 90 centimeter deep octa?
Sorry, I didn't get.
Sir, I say that what about 90 centimeter deep octa?
What she asked is what is the minimum requirement or basic things which we can use. I said, yes, 70 centimeter octa is perfect to use. 90 centimeter also very good. And if you are using a 90 centimeter, your light should throw very good light. Okay. The more you go, the more the power you want. So if your light have very good throw, then you can go for bigger diffuser. Okay. If you don't have much throw in your light, then you have to stick to the little smaller version so that the light throw will be more. You got what I'm saying? 90 centimeter is good, but I'm telling you, your light should have very good throw.
So budgeted, hello?
Yeah, hello?
Budgeted deep octa, which is the best budget?
See, it is like, you have a lot of different brands, okay? There are a lot of different brands to buy. Same octa, okay? Same octa, if you go for Alienchrome, it will cost you $6,000. If you go for Godax, it will cost you $4,500. If you go for Simpex, it will go $3,500, $4,000 you can get. So it's varies. There is nothing
But if we go for outdoor shoots, if you use any external flashes for any outdoor shoots, it depend on light, no? Means it depend on softbox, which will give more contrast or something, more light.
No. It's about your, first it's about your light, okay? What light you gonna use, okay? After that, it comes to the diffuser. The diffuser boxes are different kinds you'll get. If you are using octa, it will give a directional light. As I said in the beginning, that octa will give you very nice directional light. It won't fill completely, but it will fill, directional. But if you're using the octa and there is two layer cloth will be there. One layer to diffuse and on top of it, another layer will be there. If you do two both and if you use full power also, you will get less light in the out. Okay. So always remember, it's not only about the softbox. It's about your light also, how much it's going to throw. I suggest if you are using a deep octa, anything 70 or 90, if your light has a 400 watts power, then it will be very nicely, it can create a very nice output actually.
Okay. Okay. User friendly means to pack or some
to pack.
We can't fix helichrome every time outdoor, right?
That is there, but carry to easy to carry is like there are Pro Photo also there and Godox also there. They have like Amberla mount. You just remove it like Amberla and you can fix. Pro Photo also has that, little easier to fix. Pro Photo is expensive and this is very cheaper side. But I will tell you why there is a difference between, I forgot to tell what works how. And any diffuser, any brand, if you use, that will have a different intensity of the light. As in, not about the intensity, the color value will, there will be slightly different. For example, if you are having a white sheet, and if you are having a half white sheet, and if you are having a light tinted blue sheet, okay, these are the three major difference will make in your image in general. So I don't want to mention those brands, but I'll tell you there will be a difference between those things. The cloth matters a lot, okay? If you are using one brand this side, one brand diffuser, and if you are using another brand this side and another brand diffuser, there will be a color variation for sure. Not 100% it will match. There will be a 10 to 15%. Definitely there will be a difference in the tone of the image. You got right what I'm talking about? Yeah. Anybody else?
Hello, sir. This is Siddharth.
Yeah, Siddharth.
I just want to know how you use the white balance for indoor and outdoor shoots. Like, you have any preference or?
Okay, I will tell you little. It's not about secret. Okay, it's only about first understand your ambience. Okay, ambience makes a lot of difference. If you have a white background at your studio or a place where you're going, then your light will reflect differently. Okay. If you have a dark background or if you have a green, blue background, it will definitely do a different feel to the image. So always remember that thing and then you calibrate as in change your Kelvin setting. I will tell few points which I use. Generally, my studio, it's white only. If it is having more of a white tone, cooler color, okay, then it works at 4646. That means 4600 Kelvin, that white balance works. This is Andaz. You have to use that one only. It's not mandatory, but I am telling you, 48 will work. When I do a presentation, that mud background, you saw a mud place, that girl standing last few shots, there I have to reduce around 4000 or 38 because that mud was very red and it was reflecting very badly on the subject. You got what I'm saying? So there I used around 4000 to 3800 to 4000. So always remember how see your ambient. Okay, if the ambient is very warm, then you make your Kelvin less, as in 4000 3800 and stuff like that. If your ambient is very orange feel, which is warmer side, you have to reduce. If your ambient is very lit, well lit, and it's looking very cooler tone or whiter tone, then you can stick with 4600 or 52 also, you can use sometime. Siddharth, it helped you, I guess.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Yeah,
thank you. Anyone else?
Sir, I want to know about the flash power or strobe light power to use in 70 centimeter deep octa or 90 centimeter deep octa or 120 centimeter deep octa.
Okay, first you tell me, when you use your flash, you use manual mode or TTL mode?
Manual mode.
Manual mode. Okay. So very much important to understand when you use a flash, if you are using a TTL or a manual. I generally use manual mode only because you will understand at least how much power your light is going to throw. Again, I will tell you, whatever you're going to choose, your either 60 centimeter or 90 centimeter or 120 centimeter, the power is going to remain the same. If I say keep 1 by 1, sir, it will be enough. Power is going to be same, correct? But if you are not, if you are going to use in 60, if you are going to use 120, makes a difference on throw because of the soft box. When you use a 120, it will give little soft light. Okay. When you use a, when you use a 70 centimeter, then it's going a little harsh light. Okay. And also, and how much diffuse you're going to do. Generally, Octa will come two diffusion section. Okay. There will be a cloth in inside and one more cloth outside.
Right, sir.
So that is depends on that. So always remember, I told you in the beginning how the light will react on the subject and how far you're going to keep your 120 or 70 centimeter octa also matters. If you are using a 120 closer to the subject, it's going to throw a lot of light. If you're going to use the 120 centimeter octa little far, say 5 feet or 6 feet, then it will give a very nice diffused image. Okay, same thing you can achieve with your 70 centimeter. If you are keeping your 70 centimeter closer, it's gonna make lot of light. If you are keeping at 3 feet or 3.5 feet, it's gonna give the same output what it gave in 120. But only the radius or dia of that throw of the light will be different. So it will cover less, that will cover more. That's it. But you can achieve the same result with all the things.
So sometimes the shopkeeper says that if you use 120 centimeter, then the flash power should be what?
No, I didn't get your voice was breaking, sir.
Sir, I say that sometimes shopkeeper says that if you use 120 centimeter deep octa,
okay,
then the flash power must be 600 watt.
Flash power must be 600 watt. See, yeah. That's what I told you. It all depends on the place also matters. Where you gonna shoot? You gonna shoot indoor or outdoor? And how much ambient light is gonna impact on your subject? After that, you gonna throw your external light, right?
Right.
So that's why I'm saying if you are using a 70 centimeter also, 120 also, it's fine. But understand the distance between you and the subject and the light. Okay, that is very much important, which is going to affect your subject. So I don't want to blindly say that, sir, you put one by one only and you use F5.6 and ISO 200, it will get no. It's not going to help like that. It's all depends on each and every place matters a lot. When I start the presentation, I was very bright. Now the light is gone, so I'm looking dull. So all depends on the light distance matters. Light power will be the same, but the distance is definitely matters a lot. So always remember that. I'm telling you again, don't trust anything. Just do yourself. I'm telling you, if you are keeping one by one also, you change the distance between from your subject to the light. You will see a lot of different. Then you understand what is required. I believe the source light can be the same, but the distance and the angle matters a lot.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Thanks, Arup.
Sir, Siddharth here again.
Yeah, Siddharth.
Yeah, so I have one question. Like when you told with two lights also we can do the fashion photography. So is there any calculation between the field light and the key light distance with the subject with the power? Or is there an experimental?
No, definitely. See, I will tell you, key light will be any which case it will be well lit. You agree with that? And then there will be a kick light or a fill light will be less light. Okay. If you are using here 4.5 and you can use here 2.5. This is just an example. I am not saying you have to keep only that. Again, I'm telling you like Mr. Arup asked, the distance matter and what kind of, light you're going to throw matters a lot. Okay. Always there will be a difference when you use a main key light. That is more light, and any fill light or kick light will be little lesser than your key light.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Would anyone like to ask a question, or can we take some from chat? I think most of the questions have already been answered.
Sir, one question is in my mind.
Yeah.
That sir, are you use light meter in modeling shoot?
See, if you have a light meter, it will be very great. You don't have to worry about anything. You just test it and you can click it. Nowadays, everyone is using digital camera. If your image is not good, just delete and change the exposure and click. Those are the two things which you need to keep in mind. Okay. Light meter and color meter, if you have, you're awesome. You don't have to worry about anything. Wherever the light is there, and you just check it and you can shoot. I have used 80% of the images, not used any light meter. Okay. It all comes from the experience, and you'll understand how the light will react. If you know how the light is going to react, of course you can make nice images. And if you have a light meter, definitely yes, it's a very big plus point for you, because you don't have to worry about what is going to happen. You just set the light meter and shoot.
Right.
Yeah, yeah.
Which light meter you recommend for the color?
I have seen few as a Celcon or something like that. I can share with you. I can share with the team, and then you can get. I have to check really good things if you want. Okay, so
okay.
I have
but
to do.
Now Sonic is collaborated
Sonic.
With the Godox.
Yeah.
And some other type of light meter.
Yeah, Sonic is it's a kind of cheap and best thing which everyone prefers right now. And I suggest, yes, if you are very much into that, if you want to make it, you can go ahead and buy them. But there are a lot of different varieties are there, different models are there. You have to check them and buy them. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Great. So we have shared Sir's all Instagram handle and all the handles where he's available. So if you have later on any questions, you can follow him, drop him questions. He will be happy to answer, I'm sure.
Definitely, yes. Definitely, yes.
All right, sir. We have one question, sir. Sometimes cloth colors are reflecting on the model's face. How to avoid this reflection?
Good question. Okay. First, it's like very difficult part to make, to understand this, but how much the light you're going to throw on the subject and the product matters a lot. You have to play a little with your light. It's not only, there will be a reflection. There will be a color little, it comes on. I will tell you why it comes. If you are not shooting in your lower aperture, like, you are not cutting the ambient light. If you are not cutting the ambient light, that will definitely reflect, because the light throw also matters a lot. And after that, it will hit in your subject dress, and it will reflect on the cheeks and stuff like that. If you cut completely the ambient light and then you lit, I think you got what I'm saying. I will tell you again. If you are setting for an ambient light, and then if you are throwing an external light on top of it, and if you are in a one stop down, definitely there will be a reflection on the cheek for sure. And also what kind of colors they wear also matters a lot. And second part, you need to think of the what kind of makeup also matters. If you have a matte finish, you will get less reflection of the cloth colors to the face. Always remember that, okay? And why I am saying about ambient light is, in general, if you are not using an external light, if you are using only ambient light, definitely it's a natural thing which comes on the shoulder or any part of the body, and it will definitely reflect. And major thing, you need to understand what color it reflects more, because some camera pickups lots of green, and some camera picks lots of red. So you need to adjust the perfect Kelvin for that also matters. Then you can little avoid. It is very difficult to you cut only that light in the shoulder or somewhere, you know. You have to showcase the complete garments also, and you need to make. I believe you are using more of a natural, natural light than if you are adding a light or no, I don't know. But if you cut the ambient light completely, and if you use only your lights, external lights, then you can avoid a lot, because camera reads more light. Okay, even you have ambient light also, and top of it, if you use an external light also, it will take more light. It will read more light, So then the colors matters. So two suggestion: try to avoid shiny makeup. Second suggestion is like try to cut the ambient light and only lit with your external light will help. Other than that, I'm not too sure about anything else I can tell you right now.
Great, sir. Yeah. We have a question from Janum. How to light up a group of four or more persons so that all get soft light?
Okay. So it's very simple thing. I'm coming back to the same point. You need to understand the light. Okay. Very simple thing. You should understand the light. If you are using only one, flashlight also, you can lit everyone very soft. Only matters is the distance between you and, distance between the subject and the light, right? That's what you need to understand. So if you want to give a soft light, you have to use a very nice big octa, say 135 centimeter octa with one light, not in full power. You have to give little less power. It has to be kept 4 or 5 feet away. And here you need to play with a little bit less, a little bit more on your F number. So say 2.8 or 4 if you keep, and then adjust the rest with the light, then you will get much better softness in your image. If you are using your aperture at 7, 8, 9, 10, then the image will look very crisp and the light will look very sharper. Okay, when you use the light in a sufficient distance and little filling completely, and if you are, see, I will tell you, your aperture matters a lot and shutter speed also matters a lot. That is a different story. But what you are asking is to fill a soft light. I suggest get on nice light, big light, or you have to bounce the light. If you have a flash or if you have only one light, you flash, and also your ceiling should have white color. Okay, if it is a darker color, and that will also reflect on the subject. So if the ceiling is white, either you can reflect or use a nice big octa, keep more distance. F4 or 2.8 also will work nicely, and all depends on the how much power you're going to throw. Then you will get the diffused soft look on the image.
Thank you, sir. One last question, I believe. Can the key light be a continuous, or will that give a better result?
Key light will be a continuous light, you're saying, as in instead of using a strobe light, is it? Who asked here?
It's a TD.
Okay,
TD fly. You are in the meeting, so if you could probably.
Yeah, I'm just moving it. Okay, what he asked again? Come again. Sorry, I didn't get.
So he has asked, can the key light be continuous? Will that give a better result?
See, continuous light means what light you're going to use. You're going to use a LED light or you're going to use a sun gun. Matters a lot. So from my experience, if you ask me, if you are using a continuous light, like a LED light or anything, you can get a nice image. But when you want a sharper image, more sharper image, if you ask me, strobe light will give much better result than continuous light. As a picture I'm talking about. So I suggest you can combine both and shoot, that's not an issue. But again, continuous light, I won't suggest continuous light for for a photography. Yes, of course, you will get a nice image. But when you use a continuous light, you should have a good gears. You have a full frame. You have to have a very good lens, because that produces very good result to your camera. But when you have a beginner camera, some camera won't support the ISO nicely. If you bump up the ISO, noise will come or it will wash out. So I suggest, if you are having a very good camera, as in pro cameras, then yes, of course, you can play with your continuous light. But if you have a beginner camera, it won't give that punch in the image. Of course, you can try and experiment that for sure. But I personally suggest try strobe lights. Any kind of lights, external light, except a continuous light. It gives definitely a best result. Because continuous light, you need to compensate a lot of things from the ISO and your AF number or shutter speed. You won't get that tack sharp in generally beginner things. But high-end, you'll definitely get some 75%, 80% you can match for sure. But 20% definitely there will be a lag if you compare to the strobe lights and continuous lights.
Great, sir. I think that should be all. We have had a long session already. So if some of the questions are still unanswered, you can definitely get in touch with sir. And we have shared handles on the invite today. So you can check them out. You can follow him and ask the questions directly. So I would like to thank you really, really, sir, because it's been a really, really good session. We have learned a lot. We have had very few, fashion photography sessions. So, and it has been really wonderful.
Great. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, sir. It was a pleasure, Mano. It's like I never done a presentation like this. So generally I do talk and stuff like that, but still the presentation, the way it comes, it was very nice, I felt. And yes, of course, all your support, it made me a lot of things to do. Thank you so much again. We'll share meet up soon, sir. Yeah. Thank you.
Definitely have you again sometime.
Sir, Insta ID, please.
It's TJPDS. Any Facebook or Insta, it's TJPDS.
Yeah, TJPDS, if you type it on either on Facebook or Insta, both handles are same. And we have also sent it in the invite today. In your email, you might have got them.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, sir. We should let you go now. It's been
really... Thank you so much. All the participants, thanks for joining. Thank you so much. Bye. See you. Thank you. Bye.
Thank you.